Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, alien killers of all ages, the long-awaited moment has finally come. Welcome to XCOM 2, more specifically, Dranak plays XCOM 2, the show where, well, we go, we kill aliens, and I get most of my viewers that volunteer brutally murdered. Without too much further ado, let us get to it. We will be starting on commander duty, or commander difficulty, and we'll turn the tutorial on just to experience the story and also to get mad at the tactical stupidity the game will no doubt force me to do in the beginning. So, let's do it.
Excitement continues to build as city centers across the globe prepare for the 20th anniversary of Unification Day.
Thousands line up at the site of the Great Accord, celebrating the formation of the Advent Coalition.
Boo.
With their promise to humanity, 12 new gene therapy clinics will be opening in select cities by the end of the new year.
Despite the attempted attack by fringe elements, operations at the new facility in Paris thankfully remain unaffected.
In response to the unprovoked intrusion on the eve of our most beloved celebration, the speaker reaches out to us.
A small number of dissidents again repeat the mistakes of the old world.
Striking as we celebrate the benevolent savior of time and again offers only friendship and compassion. Trivial actions could never break the bond between humanity and the elders.
What if we get to kill him in particular
later?
We've
made several preemptive arrests of known collaborators. Advent again assures all citizens that today's celebrations will continue as planned.
Perfect.
Approaching position. You were right. They've definitely got their hands full today.
Stay focused. Prep gate crasher.
60 seconds.
Still as effective as ever.
Now.
I like how he stands up to tell her to trigger the explosive.
Okay, gatecrasher.
And then immediately drops back down. An armor, but some guns on the dropship would go a long way.
We need to move on the package before they figure out what we're up to. First things first, you need to get out of sight. Grab some cover near that low wall.
Copy that. Moving up.
Okay, he has a name and a voice, so he dies.
Position, but I'm exposed here.
It's better than nothing, but see if you can't find a safer position further out.
Looks like full cover ahead. Moving out.
Let me click.
Crasher 2, stay close. Keep pace with Crasher 1. Double time. We're gonna have to go through them. Stay out of sight until we're ready to strike.
Copy that.
to the shadows until you're absolutely set. We'll only get one shot at this.
In the shadows.
Concealment. Na 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 na.
Stay in low.
Don't get too close. You'll be spotted for sure and we'll lose our advantage.
Right, so if anyone doesn't know, during the concealment phase, basically the aliens don't know that we're there. But if we shoot or go into someone's vision range like that, then they get to attack us as Neil, and it just becomes a normal encounter.
Surprise on our side. Hopefully that's enough.
Remind me to thank the old man.
More explosions.
You and me both. We're not out of the woods yet. We need to take out those remaining soldiers.
Was she agreeing with cannon fodder? Or the advent officer?
Permission to engage.
Do it.
Oh, this is on rail, so it's gonna hit. This is... but... why? Move here. Better flank. Much safer.
I appreciate the bravery, but you're dangerously close.
Well, they can't
right now.
Both Stay die in the though. Tutorial, can they? Not even a damage roll displayed. They're just no, you're dead.
She's gone.
Damn it. You can't take risks like that. Watch your flanks.
So that's how you wanna play. Okay.
Okay.
Nice work.
Of course this position is super flankable in return, but
human. Us. At least there used to be. Human hybrid soldiers. Advent's reward for obedience and service.
We've all heard rumors. I just never believed it was true.
No one wanted to. But we find what we're looking for today. I promise you that's gonna change. Let's move.
Oh, that is really fast camera rotation.
I'm on it.
Keep your eyes peeled. Fire on anything that moves. The main entrance is clear. We need to move on the package.
Come on, then. Oh, I can't tab. I'm guessing you grab the loot then.
Hold up. You should check that body for salvageable gear. We need anything we can get at this point. Better move fast, though. I've heard rumors Advent rigs their stuff to self-destruct.
Got a scope, okay. Mook's dies.
Reinforcements just hit the ground.
They're getting nervous. Now I know we're in the right place.
Bum 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 bum.
Well done. Fall back to our position.
Just go. I'll try to stall him here.
But you could get to better cover. You could fall back from high cover in Overwatch. Dumbass. It's 5 feet away, you'll probably make it.
You should be able to cut right through the door's security protocols. We were never expecting anyone to get this close.
Or to shoot it. These are both super relevant, so hey. Yes, let's go stand in the middle of the room. That's a great idea, Bradford.
I hope our intel was good.
It was. Oh, no, I was wrong.
Are you sure?
Bitch, I am standing in the room. The great Commandy One. That's cool. I'm just hooked into God knows what system and you just, you know, break it instead of
let's get out of here.
Shutting it down.
The entire Advent security grid just lit up. Firebrand is holding nearby for evac, but it's now or never, Central.
Understood. We're on the move.
Apparently, we just broke into something they consider important. No, okay, he does die.
No! Central, Crasher One is down. You have to get out of there.
We need another exit, now!
All of the building, if they follow reasonable fire codes, there should be more than one door.
Got it covered.
Oh, and I magically have grenades now. You know, if we'd had this earlier, we could have just blown up that first pod.
Fire in the hole.
Works for me.
They can move full speed, but the animation is slower. So, does Bradford play Lone Survivor?
Way too close.
That's at least one miss. Of course it fails to kill Bradford. Although it would be hilarious if he dies in the tutorial. It would be an unexpected twist.
We need an immediate evac. Get us out of here.
Pretty sure it's not actually instant like this, but...
Keep moving!
You don't need to tell me twice.
That's a tile I'm gonna evac to, huh? Let me... click.
We're coming home!
Bye-bye. Yoink! Someone's angry. Codex. Yeah. We don't want to fight those anytime soon. They're mean. Also, they're female. Why are all the aliens female now? Because that has boobs. Doesn't necessarily mean female, I guess, because aliens, but still, you know what I mean.
Carefully! There's potentially decades of
yes.
Atrophy to contend with.
Wish we had more time.
I don't disagree. But as it stands now, we risk losing the patient if we don't begin the removal procedure immediately.
We're ready.
You think the aliens would just have, like, a low jack in that or something?
Remarkable. Just like 20 years ago. We were still calling it a war back then. We had no idea what was coming.
Response from the cerebral cortex.
Good.
Prepping for cranial intrusion.
Yep.
I've managed to identify the connection. Preparing to make final incision.
These readings are getting really erratic.
Of course they are. These implants were never designed to be removed. We are risking severe...
No plan B here, people. Do it.
Why would an enemy unknown muton be punching me in the face?
Procedure.
Or no, I mean, XCOM 2 muton.
Told him it would take more than that to keep you down. Welcome back.
Commander.
Glad to see you're finally coming out of it. Don't envy the headache you must have, though. Still, can't fault Dr. Tigan. Especially as no one's even attempted something like this before. Easy. We're still not entirely sure what they did to you.
They stuck
that
a thing in my brain.
Buried halfway into your skull. Lost a lot of good soldiers looking for you over the years. Almost gave up hope you were still out there. Acted on the intel as soon as I got word. Not sure what you remember, but a lot's changed.
You have a beard
now.
Did
the best I could, but the last 20 years have been tough without you.
At least facial hair.
You feel like catching up. Shen has the archive up and running on your terminal. Otherwise, I'd go see Dr. Tigan when you're ready. There's some things you should know. He'll be better at explaining them than me. It's damn good to have you back, Commander.
Alright, guess we're going to research next.
Impressive, isn't it? Capable of generating immense power, yet completely harmless to human life. If only the same could be said for the rest of the aliens' technology, Commander.
If it
Dr.
could be,
Richard Tigan,
we
Chief
be
Science
here.
Officer, I am responsible for the entirety of our research here, as well as the procedure you so recently underwent. Welcome to my lab, such as it is. I'm not sure what Central may have told you, but we found something while removing you from the alien stasis suit. A device implanted directly in your occipital lobe.
Which would be bad, right?
Had I access to the equipment available to me during my tenure at Advent, I would already know the precise nature of its function. However,
okay, so
given
you
time and
for,
your approval,
wait,
of course.
Does anyone explain
Commander,
what the hell Advent is to the Commander yet?
I will find out. Which brings to light an additional point. Though aspects of this facility are indeed impressive, I am but one man. Were you to direct additional support personnel and resources to me, I could substantially improve the speed of all our research.
Really? That's where you're going to first.
On your order, Commander. I will begin researching the Advent chip for possible insights as to its function.
Apparently that's all I can research, because tutorial.
I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
That research will keep Tigan busy for a while. In the meantime, you might want to head down to the armory.
Commander, to the armory.
Commander, Jane Kelly was instrumental in the op to get you back. She earned enough experience for a promotion. We should take care of that now.
Alright, survey says.
The Ranger serves as our primary
okay.
reconnaissance.
I wonder if this
unit,
is scripted like the Argentina heavy from the first game.
While engaging enemies at close range.
And more importantly, she has a shotgun.
We're off to a good start. Our troops will only get stronger as they gain experience.
You know, or die. One of those two things will happen.
I heard you, Shen. When we get the thing, you'll be the first to know.
When we get the thing. Okay, I like Bradford more this time.
Give me a second. Execute echelon protocol.
Attention. Senior command exchange confirmed.
I had wanted that to be a little more ceremonious, but we've got something.
So we instantly go between
this hybrid magnetic
proximity alarm and you're in charge now.
They track the device to a nearby Advent convoy and are attempting to take it down. If we can bring this converter back in one piece, we might actually get this place up and running and give the aliens a real war for a change. A squad is prepped and ready to launch on your order, Commander. Just give the word.
Okay. Is this a real mission? Must be, because I can access loadouts and stuff. Alright, let us go do it.
engage with resistance forces in the area have gone dark, which can only mean one thing. These people sacrificed everything to give us this shot. We need to recover that converter at all costs.
Or they went into radio silence, or they had been to some sort of jamming interference stuff going on. Well, Bradford just assumes everyone's dead. That's why you're not the commander, Bradford. Our ranger looks suspiciously like one of the base defense people from the original game, but maybe it's just the hat. Press any key. So I click it. I click the spot where it says that. Ah, because insertion. Insertion never changes.
Commander, getting a fix on the device, but it looks like it may have been damaged during the fight. Energy readings are going crazy. I'm guessing we don't have much time before it explodes.
Of course we don't. Because we would damage the thing that we came to capture. That is...
Shen's working on a way to stabilize that thing, provided we can get close enough to access its core. Stay in the shadows until we can get a better read on the situation.
Okay, well, let us go do things. Some vehicles, indestructible cover, lovely.
Moving out.
And we're just gonna push hard, try to set ourselves up to have
all over it.
Extra time when we do make contact.
The Advent officers seem Officer more capable than grunts. We're not sure whether to chalk it up to training or stricter mind control. Commander, we have a chance to do some serious damage here. Before jumping into combat, let's make sure we make the most of our advantage. So next turn we go out on these guys.
Understood. Moving out.
do it. Damn it. Alright, so he dies for sure to a grenade.
They spotted us.
Hopefully they cluster and I can grenade both of them.
These guys make up the bulk of the Advent forces we've dealt with. They're
yes, that should
well
be
equipped, but their obedience makes them predictable.
No, it is not. Okay.
Rangers are uniquely equipped for close quarters combat. In the right situation,
my ranger can move up and shotgun that. But you're close enough, you should get a range bonus, so we'll actually have you.
On my way!
And if you haven't noticed, I've been joined by my, we'll say co-commander, my daughter.
Headed there now.
So we'll move up to where we flanked. Good day.
Enemy destroyed.
Keith, damn it. You know what? We will just double grenade you, guarantee the kill. Now we'll have to double back towards the computer. Or computer, the convoy.
Designated position.
Affirmative, moving out. Objective in range.
Okay, you should be able to hack into that thing's safety protocols and stabilize it. Shen is uploading the fix right now.
Come on. I'm pushing Y. Why can I not overwatch? These key bindings, tactical shortcuts. Overwatch is why. Target is there. Let's try to keep over this way a little bit. That is not cover.
Move it on target location.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Good copy. Moving on target. Moving on target location.
Four turns. I'm basically three moves away.
Affirmative, covering now.
Hear that? Alright, happy I overwatched. Do some damage. Run towards us, run towards us. I got more overwatch for you guys.
We've got Advent here. Let's go.
Now the other two are probably too far back to get shots. Nope.
Missed.
One health left on an officer.
Commander, we're running out of time here. If we don't stabilize the converter soon, I don't think anybody.
Yes, yes, yes. I know, Bradford. All right. Who has their grenades left? this far. So we can guaranteed kill that, but then that leaves us shooting at the trooper. Can we get flanks? No. Here, one tile off of flanking. Well, good to know some things haven't changed.
Understood. Moving out.
Ah, crap. I just realized my mic has been muted for... Oh, fuck.
Although they bear some
resemblance crap baskets.
First encountered during the invasion, their genetic structure now...
That is fairly terrible.
They are stronger than ever, with an even greater psionic potential.
So I can peel the rest of the goons, my... grenade left.
Get ready for a surprise!
Loot destroyed. Oh well, so be it. I think I need to save the grenade. I would slash, but I can't actually do it from cover anywhere.
Moving to designated coordinates.
So next turn we have to get someone at least within a blue move of the computer. Good.
Hostiles pacified. Weapons burning ammo back.
Nah, I think you just have to get a high cover.
Solid copy.
Try to go for flanks next turn. Can I get my shotgun to bear on you at close over on the corner? Yeah, I made a zombie, that's fine, that's
no respite for the dead. The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
Good, 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 good.
Can't move.
So the Overwatch is annoying. We may just have to run that. Probably just have to run that so that you can try to get flank off. Okay. The Overwatch removed, I guess. So, if you can kill him, we can go all in on the sectoid. 85%, do it! Nice. Nice, nice, nice.
Hostile neutralized.
That was just some silly good luck for us that truck blew up.
Running low.
That's the move we wanted. Hooray for sectoids being weak to melee.
Good riddance.
I'll light you on fire, but...
Moving to designated position.
You'll hack it before you take damage, I believe.
It
Wait, what? Why can't you... Well, god damn it.
Order's confirmed. On the move. Double time. Getting a little too warm over here! Getting a little toasty here! Alright, that one hurts!
Okay, 1 point of damage. That should be armor.
Commander, the converter is near collapse. It's about to blow.
Bradford, shut up. I am working on it. She just... Apparently you cannot hack while you're on fire.
Let's see what we've
Good
got.
Good to know, I guess. There are no current dark event stuff, so... Okay. Oh.
We're in. Gear is secure.
Well done. Readings are returning to normal. Well, mostly normal. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
One wounded. Shouldn't be for too long. Although technically the most under fire award should actually go to the one that was lit on fire, but you know, technicalities. These loading screens, so this is gonna get old. They really, really, really old. Thank you.
People earned well-deserved promotions, Commander. I'm guessing Shen will probably want to have a word with you, too. Operating some of our most advanced equipment, specialists deploy robotic drones on the battlefield that can be outfitted for combat or field medic duty.
Alright, so we got a specialist. I'm gonna assume a sharpshooter.
Just like it sounds, our
fabulous hair flowing.
Enemy targets with pinpoint accuracy from extreme range. They're also trained in pistol marksmanship for the occasional close encounter.
Squad sight is less brokenly powerful than.
Serving as our demolition experts, the Grenadiers provide heavy ordnance delivery whenever and wherever we need it.
As long as you only need it twice per mission.
These items should prove useful in a...
Why are you all just standing around? It's perfect. Come on! Let's get it inside.
Glowing alien thing that we're not entirely certain what it does. Let's just plug it into the middle of our ship. It's super legit, I promise. And let's go meet Shen.
Okay, reworked your repulsors with some of the parts I salvaged from their old engine. Should fix that stabilization problem you had. Come on, Rover. It'll work.
Orange over. Silently Shen over.
Getting our tech to talk to theirs is harder than you'd think.
No, I think it's pretty difficult.
At your service. You were probably expecting to see my father. In all that's happened, I'm guessing Central didn't tell you yet.
No, he's left out a few details.
Oh. Dad gave everything he had to get us this far. This entire ship is his life's work. I know he would have loved to show you around the place himself. He used to talk about you a lot. You can be sure I'm ready to finish what he started. Might not look it, but from here, I can fabricate pretty much anything you come up with. And with a little more help, well, you'd be amazed with what I can do.
Well, at least she's more subtle than... It was an honor to finally meet you. More subtle than Keegan Tygan for about asking for help. I can respect that.
I can't promise any miracles, Commander, but I should be able to put some of the stuff together in no time at all. I'd suggest we get started with a med kit. It'll probably come in handy sooner rather than later.
Well, it looks like I don't have a choice, so...
I'm on it, Commander.
Looks like Tygan...
Much of my own research based upon this simple design. If only I had known. Ah, Commander, excellent timing. There's been some progress. I've managed to break down several key components of the ship implanted into your skull. My analysis reveals that its primary function was that of a conduit, passing a vast amount of data directly to your cerebral cortex. With the primary connection severed, much of that data is lost. Several fragments do remain, however. Ghosts, if you will. Observe. Tactical combat simulations. War games. The sheer volume of encounters you were processing was astounding. It is truly remarkable that you survived as long as you did.
So are the aliens using music? Or are they just trying to gain data from
this chip? Bears a striking resemblance to a medical implant I briefly assisted in developing at the gene therapy clinic in New Providence. My understanding was that the implants were intended for high-ranking Advent officers only, captains or above. Retrieving a chip from such an officer would be the only way to know for certain.
Well,
greater understanding of these implants would undoubtedly benefit us all, Commander.
New objective added.
The Advent officers have clearly been modified to allow for their subordinates to receive new orders psionically.
Gun upgrades.
The implanted chip is the key.
Are we finally...
I do find that area of research to be among the more intriguing
options
available.
No, we're still on rails a little bit.
We'll begin work immediately. I'll send word when a complete report is available.
Looks...
Just stay clear of the perimeter, understood?
Commander, good.
I think we got something here.
Despite all of Advent's efforts, there are still people who refuse to believe their lies. And it's time we let them know they're not alone. We've already located a target for our first operation.
If you hear this, you are the resistance.
There's actually no way the Sky Ranger could reach that position.
Who said anything about the Sky Ranger? Shen, status report. Are we ready?
Short answer, yes. But you might all want to hold on to something.
Short answer, yes. If the answer is yes, why is there a long answer? Oh, we're still on rails, huh?
We're ready to start making moves, Commander. By hitting Advent wherever we find them, we can help strengthen the resistance. In return, they'll contribute material and personnel to support our operations. Commander, it looks like Shen prepped a med kit for us. We should equip one of our soldiers with it before they deploy.
But Oh, yeah, whatever. We'll get the sniper and the medkit, I guess, then. I don't really want to. But if you're going to require me to equip it... No, that's right, my heavy is wounded. Oh, well. Alright, and that's where we're going to pick it up next time with Operation Smoking Prince. Also, I should have just forgot. I was supposed to customize a couple of my starting troops, but we'll do that off camera, and I will show them off next time. So we will see you all then.